Okay, what I'm going to show you is how to add pocket holes to your model. What I'd first like to do is to add a layer for the pocket holes so that they can be hidden at a later time. So we'll create another layer and we'll select that as our current layer. So anything that we add right now will be added to the pocket holes layer. So what we'll do is we'll take our shells and we'll hide them, and we're going to edit one of our sides here. According to our plans, our side B should have several pocket holes, two on each side and three on the top as a minimum. So we'll edit our component by just double clicking it. And we'll go into the components and we'll actually search through the components box here in the Google Warehouse, 3D Warehouse. We'll search for Craig Pocket Hole. And it should come back with a list. And according to our plans, we want for the sides 2.5 inch long pocket hole screws with 1.5 inch holes. So we're going to look for the 1.5 inch holes. So whatever face we put it on is what face it will go on. And we're also going to need to use the 3/4 inch pocket holes for the top holes. And one of those will be in the middle, so I'm just going to place it in the middle. Okay, so we have both that we'll need. So what we'll do is we'll rotate this one into the right direction and we'll move it to the midpoint on the edge, and we'll move it up 0.75, and we'll copy it down 1.5, and we should have both of them there. Now we'll select them both, and we want to move a copy over to the other side. And we'll scale them to -1. And we'll move them over to the edge. We'll also want to copy our top holes. Let's try 15. That looks okay. So we'll also move the other side 15. And when we look at our model, we'll see that every one of those pieces has the same pocket holes. So next we'll do the side pocket holes. And they're going to be the same way. So we'll edit this component. We'll go to our components. This time we're actually going to choose the ones in the model without searching. Our 1.5 inch and our 3/4. We'll rotate our side pocket hole. Move it up 0.75. Copy it down, 1.5. Select the two of them, make a copy, scale it to -1, move it into position. Going to move these both 6 as a copy. And then all of our joinery is complete. Now another thing we could do is to adjust the information in the outliner for our components. Okay, what we'll do is we'll edit our pocket holes to show what size screws they have. And if you have more than one size screw for a particular size pocket hole, you can make each pocket hole unique or make a second set. It basically makes a copy of the component. So in this case, they're going to be the same, so we won't use the make unique. We're going to select the pocket holes of the 1.5 inch. And the ones that are drilled 1.5 inch, it says take a 2.5 inch long pocket hole screw. So we'll put that in, 2.5 inch screw. And if we look at the other part B's, they'll be the same. We'll just edit our part C's. And the other part C's will be the same. Now we'll just edit our other joints here. The ones that are drilled at 3/4, it says it needs a 1.25 inch long pocket screw. So, let's see here. Take these three, and we want a 1.25. And that's how we do our pocket holes. It's useful to add the lengths of the screws so that if you have more than one length of screw for a particular hole, you know which are which and how many of each you're going to need.